If you smell like BO, there's just nothing to do. Hi, my heavenly scented friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about longevity. So many people out there, I would say the internet is obsessed with longevity. How long does that fragrance last? How can I make it last longer? So I'm going to be answering these questions today, and it all starts from the bottom. It all begins with body care. I wanted to film like a whole body care routine, but I didn't really have the time for that. So today I'm going to talk you through the products that I use. And men especially, please watch this video, because the reason why fragrances aren't lasting long on your skin is because it's dry. So before you go ahead and moisturize your body, it's super duper important that you have exfoliated. So using different tools for exfoliation, you can use either a washcloth while you're in the shower, you can use a dry brush. This is kind of old and icky, but still works. So this is a brush that you use before you go into the shower, if you prefer that. You can also use those mittens. I have mine in the shower and they're still wet, so I didn't bring them out. But you need to absolutely get rid of all of the dead skin that's on your body to make space for the moisturizer so that it really sinks into your skin. Now, I make it a point to try to get products that are as natural as possible, so with the most natural ingredients, because fragrance, I hate to break it to you, but it's a toxin. It's not exactly the best thing unless you're using 100% natural fragrances, which there aren't that many out there. So when it comes to shower gel, the one that I love is this one from Antipodes Natural Ingredients. It's called Nirvana, and it smells like Nirvana. It's heavenly. It's a black currant mixture with spearmint and cardamom, and this is really great. And what's nice is that after the shower, this doesn't have a lingering scent, so it's not going to clash with any of the fragrances that I apply afterwards. I switch up my game on a daily basis, multiple times a day when it comes to fragrance. I spray different things, so I don't want to be wearing anything on my body that's going to compete with my perfume. If you don't care about that and you are looking for scented products, then Roger & Gallet do some really nice ones. And when it comes to like fragrance products that smell actually perfumey, I always turn to French Pharmacy. Another option if you're feeling bougie is to get an actual shower gel from a fragrance brand. So this is Helfetti by Penhaligon's, and this was a gift. I don't spend this much on shower gel. So once you're all clean and scrubbed up, you're gonna need a deodorant, obviously. Like, it doesn't matter how wonderfully scented your fragrance is. If you smell like BO, there's just nothing to do. So I am a big advocate for natural deodorants. It does take some time to find the one that works for you. I'll leave a link below for this one. It's a cream one. You might feel like a cream deodorant is a hassle because, you know, it gets on your hands. You have to wash your hands after applying it. But because this is natural, you can literally just like get rid of it like that. Rub your hands together. And if you have a little residue, just treat it like moisturizer because it's natural, so it's fine. A deodorant that I feel is pretty widespread is the one from Green People. If any of you know this brand, it's a natural brand. And these ones actually work for me and my partner. This one is Quinoa and Prebiotics. They have prebiotics in there, which is a healthy bacteria. So somehow having that healthy bacteria stops your armpit from creating nasty bacteria. So worth checking out the Green People deodorants. Once that's done, you need to moisturize. And you can do this with either a lotion, an oil, or a butter. I have dry skin, so I prefer butters and oils. And you don't need to break the bank when it comes to moisturizers. Like literally, you can just go on Amazon, get yourself a big bottle of almond oil, or whatever oil you prefer. If you have dry skin, go for almond. If you prefer something lighter, go for jojoba oil. I really like that. And you can just moisturize with this. There's no scent. It's not going to clash with anything. It's super easy to apply after your shower. A lot of the males that I know don't want to moisturize. Like, it's a tedious task, even females. Like, moisturizing can be annoying, but it's such an important step. Do not skip out on moisturizing. A hack that I found when it comes to moisturizing is using a scrub in the shower that contains oils in it. So instead of moisturizing and exfoliating separately, you can get a natural scrub, or you can make one yourself very easily with sugar or coffee grounds and an oil. Literally mix that together. And while you're in the shower and you've cleansed, then you're exfoliating with this scrub, it's gonna leave some oil residue on your body. And I do this when I'm in a hurry, and it actually works. Not as well as applying a body butter and an oil and all of that, but there's something on the skin. If you are the type of person that has one signature fragrance and can then layer products with the same scent on top of each other, that helps a whole ton with longevity. So I have the Baccarat Rouge 540 fragrance body oil, and this was a gift as well. So basically, I always ask for scented body products because that's something that I don't spend money on. I spend my money on the fragrance, and people don't necessarily want to buy me fragrance because, you know, I have particular tastes and all of that. So I ask for body products that are scented. And if no one gave me this, I would just be happy with my almond oil. That's fine. Then you have the option of applying body butters. And if you have super duper dry skin, then apply oil first and then a butter on top, and you're gonna be greasy and good to go. No ashiness whatsoever. So two products that I like is this product by Nuxe. It's Bio Beauté. So I got this like at TK Maxx on sale, and it's a French pharmacy product. So the scent is lovely. This is nice and invigorating orange. And then I love the brand Velita. This is a German brand that has been doing natural products for years and years. So they're not greenwashing. They've always been doing it. This packaging is recycled materials, and the butter itself, it smells like skin food. Basically, their skincare product. They have a cream called Skin Food, and it's a neutral scent. It smells all right, and it's not too overpowering, so it's not gonna compete with my fragrance. Another scented body product that I like, this is actually the same brand as the scrub that I showed you, and this is Evolve Organic Beauty. They have lovely scented products, and apparently they're 100% natural and handmade. I'm gonna leave links to these below, but they have a wonderful, it's called the Tropical Blossom scent, and it smells like Monoi, like the Monoi flower, and it's sweet, tropical, beautiful. It's just a gorgeous scent, and usually I don't like scented body products, but that one I've purchased time and time again. For the bougie option in the body product department, we have these body lotions by Hermès. I absolutely love these. This one is the Crème de Merveille. This one smells like Ombre de Merveille from Hermès, which is just wonderful, delightful. So I will wear these maybe at nighttime when I'm not gonna be wearing a fragrance on top, because the scent is so powerful with these. They are very pricey. This one is the Jour d'Hermès one, and pretty much they last like 12 hours. So they are worth the money in my opinion. I forgot to mention that you can easily add scents to your body oil. So if you just take your carrier oil and get some essential oil, this one is Lang Lang, then just add it in or blend it together separately, and then you have a lovely scented product. This is a product that I finished, and then I just kept the bottle, and now I create my own body oils in this. Whew. Okay, so we've gone through all of the body products that I use to help make my fragrances last. We can't all be carrying a bottle around with us to top up, although I'd love to. That's not always a possibility. So you can make your fragrance last by following these steps, staying moisturized, and yes, good luck.